Now see, you will tell me which chapter are we going to study. You will find out the page number. You will tell me where it is. I will ask you. Okay, those who are listening to me, tell me yes. How many are listening to me?
Yes.
Only one student.
Yes.
Two.
Yes.
Okay. Three. So only three students I am teaching. Four students still.
Yes.
Only four.
Yes.
Sir.
Yes.
Means there are 17 students, but only four are listening. That means.
Yes, sir.
Okay. Yes, five. Six.
Yes, sir.
Still only six. So around 10 students are just attending the lecture but not attentive. So I am writing down their names. Those who did not say yes. Means they are there in the lecture but they are doing something else. They are doing some other work.
Yes.
Yeah.
Okay, seven. Eight.
Yes.
Still eight students are there.
Yes,
still seven
sir.
Are there. Okay. So that 6 to 7 students, those who have not said yes, I am noting down their names, means they are not attentive. I will not give their names to anyone, don't worry. But
yes,
I will
sir.
Know that in my lecture, how many are attentive. Yes, I heard you, don't worry.
Yes.
Kasim, I heard you.
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir, Shepardian.
Now, there is a question on the screen. There is one. So what do you answer that question? Should you believe everything you hear or read? Everything that you read in the book, any book, or everything that you hear from the people, should you believe all that things? Yes or no?
No, sir.
See, is it possible? It is raining cats and dogs. Can cats and dogs rain?
No. No.
But what if I say it is right? Then you will say, sir, have you gone mad? How is it possible
yes.
that cats and dogs will fall down like rain? But I am saying it is right. Do you all support me?
No.
But what if I prove it is right?
Then.
Anyone who agrees with me?
Prove it.
Yes, sir. I agree.
If you agree, then tell me the reason. Why do you agree? Isn't it wrong? It is raining cats and dogs. So, do you believe that?
Cat and dogs.
Do you believe what was written? It is raining cats and dogs. Anyone who believes?
Sir, then. Hello.
No.
Yes.
One person taking so many cat and dog from one place to another by the air or plane.
Okay. Understood what you are trying to say. That from the plane, cats and dogs are falling down like that. But it is not like that. What was written, do you believe? No. People say,
yes.
It has been written in the books.
No.
But in many books, this sentence has been written. People have read this. It is raining cats and dogs. It is written in so many books. I can show you. So why do people say that? And why is it written in so many books? Something would be there. Some reason would be there. Do you know the reason behind that? Are they lying? Do they mean it literally means?
Yes.
Really, they mean what was written? It is raining cats and dogs. So really, literally, they mean that, or are they lying?
Oh, lying.
They are lying. Are you sure?
Yes.
But now I'm going to prove it that they are not lying. They mean it in a different way, not literally. Actually, the cats and dogs cannot fall down like that. It cannot rain. But what is the reason? No, they are making a point, exaggerating the point by use of idioms. It is an idiom. It is compared. What is the meaning then? Exaggerating means what? Do you know the meaning of this word?
No.
Exaggerating means to say something more than what is needed. You know, sometimes we speak when we add mirch masala and we increase that thing and we speak. That is exaggerating. Overstatement. To speak more than what is needed. That is called exaggerating. So they don't mean it literally. But yes, it is raining cats and dogs. That is right sentence. That is correct sentence. Because it is an idiom. So do you know what are idioms? Idioms and phrases. Have you heard? See, it is raining. Here it is shown rain. Here it is shown cats and dogs. So what is the similarity? What is the similarity between these two?
Both are falling down.
Idioms, phrases that mean more than their words put together. If you take them word for word, they might not make much sense. So if you read like that, it is raining cats and dogs. If you go for words, then you will think that it is senseless. It is foolish thing to say. It is raining cats and dogs. So don't go word for word. Are you getting it? When you put it together, it has a different meaning. Like how we had learnt phrasal verbs, when you put it together, it has a different meaning. Same way, idioms, when you keep all the words together, then it will make sense. But don't go for word. Then you will think that it does not make sense. Understood? Did you all understand? Did you all understand?
Yes.
Do you like my backpack? It cost me an arm and a leg. So this bag, for buying this bag, I had to sell one arm and one leg. Then I was able to buy this bag. How does it make sense? Can anyone tell me?
Sir, when we have arm and leg to take the bag. Bag.
Sir.
Yes.
If I don't have arm and leg, I could not carry a bag and I could not take the bag away. So it is saying that do you like my backpack? It cost arm and leg means it is necessary to have arm and a leg.
Okay, but you are again going word for word. Again, you are going for the words. You are really assuming arms and legs which are shown over here. But actually, arms and legs has nothing to do with this idiom. This is an idiom. That is what I am teaching you right now. I am coming to the topic. Now we are coming to the topic. You first read this sentence. it is raining cats and dogs. So there also you were going word for word, means you are again assuming cats and dogs falling down, right? Because I have shown that in image.
How we have to assume? How?
Exactly. I am coming to that point. Wait. I know you want to know that what is the meaning of this and what is the meaning of this. I'm in lag. You want to know this also. Arm and leg. How can it cost you an arm and leg? Means you will cut your arm and leg for buying a backpack. How does it make sense?
No.
So literally it will not make any sense. Means really if you read words, agar real mein words arm or leg assume karoge to kuch samajh mein nahi aayega. Then how will you understand? Now see, this is the meaning. It cost me an arm and a leg, means it cost me a large amount of money. Actual meaning is this. But those who are well versed with the language, only they can understand this. So for learning English, for improving your speech, if you want to become a good English speaker, then you have to learn idioms. Idioms are the basics. They are the base of English language. Because, you know, see, I know what are idioms, but all the people in the world or all the people in India, do you think they know the meaning of this arm and leg? When you use it in a sentence? No. But if you use it in the sentence, that means you are well versed with the language. So now you know the meaning of this sentence. Now you understood?
Yes, but cat falling, cat and dog.
That I am explaining. That. You understood what is the meaning of this now?
Yes.
Why
arm and leg is equal to a large amount of money?
Because without arms and legs, you cannot do any physical activity, any hard work, like labor work. How do laborers work hard? Physical work, and then they earn money. That's why. Without our arms and legs, we are helpless.
Okay.
So it is an idiom. See, what is the meaning of this? There is a big test tomorrow. I need to hit the books. Hit the books means will you hit the books? You know what is the meaning of hit, right?
No.
Hit.
We doesn't have to hit the books.
Sir,
to learn proper. My target is to learn this.
She forgot to write, read. She write, read.
So if tomorrow is your test, then today you have to hit the books. Means will you beat the books? We should not even think about it. So don't go word for word. I'm telling you again, don't go word for word. Really, if you think hitting the books, then it does not make any sense. I know that. But this is an idiom in English. Only those who are well versed with English, they will understand. So try to use idioms. You know, everyone around you will not understand, but then you can explain it to them. And you will really feel happy when you explain the meaning, right? What is the meaning? Hit the books means? What is the meaning of it?
Study hard.
To study hard. But not too hard.
But not too hard.
Yes. So now you know what is the meaning of this sentence?
Yes.
I need to hit the books means I need to study hard. So now, whenever you want to say to your parents or to your friends or anyone, now use this idiom that I need to hit the books because tomorrow I have got my exam. because she is under the weather.
Yes.
Yes.
Mr. Merendino is absent today because she is under the weather. Under the weather means?
No.
She is under the weather means like this. Miss Merendino. She is under the weather means like this, you can say. Under the clouds, under the rain, and it is under the weather. See, literal meaning is this. This is literal meaning. But don't go word for word, I'm telling you.
Getting that sneezing and a cough and cold.
Yes. So in short, what does it mean? Not well.
Not well.
So understood the meaning of the sentence. Feeling sick. Are you all listening?
Yes.
So from now onwards, if you want to say to your parents, to your teachers or anyone, don't say I am not well. Don't say I am not well. What will you say? Today I am feeling under the weather.
Sir, but I don't understand why the under the weather comma is equal to sick, feeling sick. Why? But
that is the meaning. What do you want to understand this?
Who can this is the meaning of the idiom. No,
you have to learn idioms.
Sir.
Idioms are like कहावत मुहावरे नहीं होते हिंदी में
yes.
मुहावरे यू कैन नॉट टेक आउट द मीनिंग ऑफ अंडर द वेदर यू कैन नॉट थिंक अबाउट द वेदर एंड अंडर द वेदर इट डज नॉट मीन लिटरली आई एम रिपीटिंग यू हैव टू लर्न इट. You have to remember the meaning of the idioms. So, the meaning of this idiom is not well or feeling sick. Got it? So, can you believe everything you read or hear? So, just now you read or heard, it was totally different. The meaning was totally different. So, can you believe everything that you read or hear? Yes or no? Hello?
Yes. Yes, sir.
What does this idiom mean? A piece of cake.
Oh. A piece of cake.
Really nice.
No.
Stop. Easy.
The sums, this exercise is a piece of cake.
Sir,
this work
you,
is a.
You tell with the sentence, okay?
This work which you have given to me is a piece of cake. The assignment that you have given for solving is a piece of cake. Understood now? See, now read the sentence. The spelling test was so easy.
I thought it was a piece of cake.
Now understood the meaning of this idiom?
Yes. The idiom says, hum to sakte uske ko kitne mile dur hai.
What? I did not get you. What are you saying?
Idiom means which we are thinking. It is two different of it.
Yes. So that is what I am saying. Literally means really. If you read the words piece of cake, to cake ke piece ki baat ho rahi hai. But actually, it is not about the piece of cake. Uska meaning hota hai easy. So literally, you are going literally, Zaki. You ask me, sir. It is too difficult, but it is very easy. You have to learn. It is nothing to take the meaning out of it. Iska meaning kuch nahi nikalta because meaning is real a piece of cake. But actually, you don't have to go for piece of cake. You have to learn the meaning. And when you learn the meanings, you can become a fluent English speaker. And you can use these idioms in front of the people and they will not understand the meaning. You can teach them the meaning. Then, see, everyone speaks this word. Easy. But have you heard anyone speaking these idioms?
Easy? No.
Ye word, easy jo word hai, wo sab bolte hai. Regularly, in everyday life. But have you heard people speaking this? Rarely we hear them. So, if you want to be a good speaker, if you want to become better than others, you stop using this word easy. Use this idiom, piece of cake. Don't say, sir, it is very easy. Sir, it is a piece of cake. We can do it easily. Got it? Yes or no? And if you are not well, what will you say? You will not say, I am feeling sick. What will you say? Yes. Then this one. Icing on the cake means? Try to guess the meaning.
Another good thing.
Okay. Wo nahi hota Hindi mein sone pe suhaga. A good thing added to another good thing. I was so happy that I scored 3 goals in the soccer game. But when I was also voted most valuable player, it was just icing on the cake. Ye samajh mein aaya sentence? See, first I scored 3 goals. That's why I was happy. But I was also given maximum votes. Yes. So first thing, I scored 3 goals, so I was really happy. Secondly, I was also voted most valuable player, means like man of the match. So 2 good things happened. That means icing on the cake. Can you make your own sentence with this idiom? Example I can give you. I scored highest in English. Then I came to know I was the one getting the first rank. So it was an icing on the cake. Understood this idiom?
Yes.
Can you make your own sentence with this idiom? Can you?
Oh, sorry, I can't.
You just give up. You just say you can't. Easily you are giving up. When you know the meaning, then also. A wild goose chase. What is the meaning of this idiom?
A pointless or useless chase. An animal chase.
A chase that is pointless or useless. Chase means what? To run after something, to go after something. It is useless. It is pointless. Then why are you running after that thing? That is called a wild goose chase. Without meaning, you do you waste your time on that, right? Jack wanted to buy new Super Mario game, but it was sold out everywhere. He went on a wild goose chase to 5 different stores and came home empty-handed. Means he wanted to buy that game of Super Mario. He knew that it was sold out in the whole city. It was not available. Then also he went to 5 stores. He wasted his time. He was knowing that the game is not available anywhere then also. So it is called wild goose chase. Means.
Can I make?
Yes.
Without studies, if you have to score a first rank, it is a wild goose chase.
Yes. Or we can also modify the same sentence. Without studying, you want to get the first rank and you appear the exam, that is a wild goose chase. One more thing, see, because of the lockdown, the shops were closed at 8 o'clock. Still, I went out at 8:30 looking for some food, knowing that it was a wild goose chase, right?
Yes.
Understood that? Then, all in the same boat. This one is very easy. Very easy it is. But you will be confused, I know. Don't go literally. Don't go word for word. Yes. People with the same problem. When the snowstorm closed the airport, you know what is snowstorm? Barf.
Yes.
Avalanche. When the snowstorm closed the airport, we were all in the same boat, stuck at the airport with no way to leave. When there was tsunami, we were all in the same boat, locked in our homes. When it was the beginning of COVID-19, we were all in the same boat. All of us were house arrest, in the house arrested position, right? We are in it together. Have you heard this? Are you all sleeping or what? I don't understand.
No, sir.
You understood the meaning of this?
Yes.
The crisis that COVID-19 has created, we are all in the same boat. We are in the same corona crisis. So we are all in the same boat. Cold feet. What does it mean? Cold feet means thandi lag gayi pair ko. What does it mean?
To be brave, fearless.
To lose your nerve. Means you lose your senses. Sara was going to play piano in the talent show, but then she got cold feet and was too afraid to enter the contest. Means, you know, you lose your senses and you sometimes you get afraid and sometimes you feel, what do you say, uncomfortable, uneasy. You feel that sometimes? Fear, sometimes you have inbuilt fear, you have instilled. Feel that sometimes or not? That is called cold feet. To lose your senses and to feel uncomfortable, uneasy. So she was about to play piano in front of the audience, but suddenly she got cold feet and she was afraid to play, to enter the contest. That is called cold feet. To lose your nerve. You remember? Now coming to our first idiom and the last idiom also, raining cats and dogs. So what does it mean actually? It was an idiom. Now you know, actually cats and dogs cannot rain. What does it mean? What
raining
does it
heavy.
Mean? Yes. Raining now heavy. See, the answer to your question is here, raining heavily. I got really drenched, means totally wet, when it started raining cats and dogs. So now onwards, when it because it is rainy season, so you will get the chance to use this idiom very soon. So don't say to anyone that it is raining very heavily. Chordar Varsache, that is called raining cats and dogs, means it is raining very heavily. So instead of using these words all the people use, common people also use these words, right? But now you are not common because you know idioms. So don't say this, use these words, raining cats and dogs. Those who don't understand, it is their problem. You have to explain it to them. It is an idiom. You tell someone, your friend, that did you see outside? It is raining cats and dogs today. Will you try to use it? What?
It's raining cats and dogs idiom.
You are not audible at all. Please speak louder.
Cat and dog. Understand.
What are you saying? You are not audible. Your voice is breaking up. Will you all use this idiom now?
Yes, sir.
I think everyone is sleeping now. Pulling my leg. What does this mean? What does this mean? Actually pulling the leg or what? What does it mean? Pulling my leg. What? Pulling my leg means to trick someone. Yes, kisi ko chidana. You pull the legs of your friends, right? You tease them, you harass them, or not? Hello?
Yeah.
I think you are all sleeping, really. Did you really meet President Barack Obama, or are you just pulling my leg? Means you tell someone that you met Barack Obama. But are you just tricking? Are you just teasing? Are you pulling leg or really you met? Pulling leg means to trick someone, to tease someone. Don't cry over the spilled milk. Means what? Doodh gir gaya. Ab roke kya fayda? Right? Don't cry over spilled milk.
Bad thing happened to you.
Something bad happened. Now move on. Means don't think about that past. Move on. See.
Enough up. Sir,
for example. Yes.
Sir, in Hindi is then.
Exactly. That is the meaning. Very good. I was about to say this. Ab pachtane se kya fayda jab chidiya chuk.